Thank you for joining this video about TinyGPT-V, a new multimodal large language model, which was introduced in a research paper titled TinyGPT-V, Efficient Multimodal Large Language Model via Small Backbones. In recent years, we've seen a tremendous progress with large language models such as GPT-4, Llama 2, and more, where we can feed the large language model with a prompt and get in response a meaningful answer. More recently, large language models have been taken another step forward by being able to also understand images. With vision language models such as the closed source GPT-4V, where V stands for vision, and open source Llama and MiniGPT-4, we can now add images to the prompt, such as the cat image ear, and we'll get a meaningful response that takes both types of inputs into account. However, these models require a substantial amount of resources to run, making them not easily accessible to all people. To overcome that, in this paper, the researchers present TinyGPT-V, a smaller language vision model that needs less resources to run, making it more accessible, yet still impressively powerful. In this video, we'll explain the TinyGPT-V paper to understand how this model was created and how it performs comparing to other models. Let's start with reviewing the model architecture. The secret sauce that helps this model to achieve good results while being relatively small is by using Phi-2 model as its large language model backbone. Phi-2 model has 2.7 billion params, yet it beats much larger models. The LLM backbone contains most of the TinyGPT-V model params, so using a small LLM such as Phi-2 keeps TinyGPT-V small. The text prompt can be directly fed into the LLM, of course, but how do TinyGPT-V leverage Phi-2 for image inputs? Given our cat image, the first step is to extract visual features from the image. We do that in two steps. First, we pass the image via a visual encoder. Specifically, TinyGPT-V is using a pre-trained vision transformer from Eva. Second, the visual features are passed via a pre-trained Q-former from Blip2, a component that is trained to align the visual features from the vision transformer with the text instruction. Then, once we have the visual features, we need to project them to be in the dimension which Phi-2 can process. We do that using two projection layers. The first is taken from MiniGPT-4 model in order to save some time in training, and another one that converts the size from MiniGPT-4 to Phi-2. Then, after pressing the projection layers, we can feed the embedded features into Phi-2, combined with the text prompt, to get an output with reasoning on both text and image. We'll expand a bit more about the training process in a minute. But in the meanwhile, we need to mention that the researchers needed to add normalization layers to Phi-2 in order to stabilize the training process. Many of the components in the TinyGPT-V model are pre-trained, so which parts are trained as part of the TinyGPT-V training? The vision transformer and Q-former are kept completely frozen during the entire process. The projection layers, even though one of them is initialized with pre-trained weights from MiniGPT-4, are both trained. Phi-2 is mostly kept frozen, except the added normalization layers which are trained, and additional LoRa weights that are also added. This way, the training process is efficient, since we don't need to train a large number of weights. Before moving on, if you enjoyed this content, please subscribe to the channel and hit the like button to help this channel grow. If you'd like to receive 1-minute read summaries by mail about the papers we review here, you may find the link to join the newsletter in the description of this video. Let's now expand a bit more about the training process of this model. We can learn about it from the following figure from the paper, where we see it has 4 training stages. The researchers refer to the first stage as a warm-up stage, where the model is trained using image text pairs. The purpose here is to let Phi-2 process the output from the projection layer and create relevant text. The second stage is pre-training. The data used here is the same as in stage 1. So what is the difference from stage 1? We can notice that in the drawing that in stage 1 the LoRa weights were not included yet. So the purpose in stage 2 is to train the LoRa weights, but the projection layers also keeps on training here. The third stage is instruction learning, where the meaning is to instructions that contain both images and text. The researchers take such example from MiniGPT-4 data, and keep on training the trainable components on such instructions. The last and fourth step is multitask learning, where here the model is trained on multiple datasets for various vision language tasks. So how does TinyGPT-4 perform comparing to other models? In the following charts from the paper, we can see the performance for multiple models on various vision language tasks. First, it is important to keep in mind here that TinyGPT-V has 2.8 billion params, while the other models here are significantly larger. Flamingo has 9 billion params, and the other models here are all with 13 billion params. We can see the TinyGPT-V results on the bottom right, and even though it is of smaller size, it is able to achieve impressive results which are comparable to larger models in various tasks. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for more reviews of AI papers.